Good evening, Limerick. Last talk. Is everybody there? Can I listen to them? I have only 3 minutes, guys. You have to answer my questions pretty fast, right? So I'm reading the newspapers, and every second day we listen about a villain called carbon dioxide. And we all say we are destroying the earth, all the global reforms and everything. How many of we have really heard a remedy? Which newspapers have actually gone that far to publish a solution? Anyone? Guys, I have only 3 minutes. Judges, I have only 3 minutes.
Trees, it's all about trees.
10 seconds extra. Anybody? No? Because carbon dioxide is not a light bulb that we can plug in and catch it up. What is the second problem? Yes, it's increasing. But by how much? Do you know? It's only 400 in a million. It means if I take this whole room, there's no carbon dioxide. Right? And we still have to catch it. Another problem, we can't see it, we can't face it, we can't smell it. And we all complain, oh yeah, it's odorless, it's senseless, and but we have to catch it. And it's supported by the second most important devil. Do you know, guys, who it is? Nitrogen, right? In the environment, you have CO2 and nitrogen, and they look the both same. One is 3.8, the other is 3.5. They both can't be seen, and you have to separate them out. With a bigger problem, nitrogen is 77% in the earth, and carbon dioxide is only 0.04. Even if they fight, can they win? No, right? So what's the answer? Can we still save or still keep crying? Global warming, global warming. And the answer lies in a very simple research, which is here. We use everything in our kitchen and we wipe it. We wipe water with that. But if I put some sand, what will happen? Right? If I take the water or the wine and I rub it, gone. What is that does that? Come on, guys. Very simple observation, and then I will show in my whole chemistry I did research. I never searched anything. I just did a research. It's the small size, which is simply called as the sieving effect. It means if somehow scientists made boxes where everything could go down, including the nitrogen. Where is this? In the pocket. Time running out. That's nitrogen. If I put it down, it goes down. Right? Nobody thought, and they all did changes. But then nobody thought of reducing this box size. What we at UWIL did in Mike Zorapka's group was, we made a small box where the nitrogen cannot fit in. It means we have eliminated 77% of the competition, and the guy can only take one thing inside it, and that's CO2, right? And it can't hold it. For an intention, we modified the other cells inside it. So now if I put it here, it goes there. No, can you tell me why? And everybody did that as well. The last thing is selective. Gases can go in and out, cannot be held. But if somehow I can put them there, it can hold it, right? So we call it pore size and pore chemistry by crystal engineering, because we want to convey a message. If you don't mend your ways today, you'll have to fend every other day. And that's true, because natural disasters are no longer natural. Okay? So this is my message to the whole thing. We have to mend our ways. Okay? Thank you, everybody. Thank you.